Hello and welcome back to Casual Gastronomy. This week we're going to be making a fall flavor inspired flatbread. But in researching this episode, I realized that I didn't really know what the difference between a pizza and a flatbread actually was. Lauren, what do you think the difference is?
To me, a flatbread is usually rectangular, doesn't have sauce, and it usually has toppings that you may not normally find on regular pizza.
I agree with that. I was a little bit confused on the definition because when I looked on the forums online, everybody was saying, oh, flatbread is made from unleavened bread, which totally makes sense. But then when I looked at the actual flatbread recipes, I found that all of the dough contained yeast. So I was a little bit confused, but I decided that flatbread is just an ambiguous food and that gives us the liberty to do whatever we want with it. So before we get started, don't forget to hit that like button if you like this video, and if you want to see more casual gastronomy, hit the subscribe button. It really helps out our tiny little channel a lot. So let's go back to yesterday and make the pizza dough.
For this recipe, you could simply use a pre-made flatbread from the store, or even a pre-made pizza dough. But because this show is more about food mastery than convenience, we'll begin by making our own pizza dough. This is actually the recipe that we used long ago for our pizza episode, but we never actually gave the recipe in that episode. Also, don't watch that episode because my hair was tragique in those days. Anyway, this dough is very simple, but you have to prepare it at least one day ahead of time to achieve the right flavor. Begin by combining 2.5 cups of lukewarm water, 1 teaspoon of sugar, and 2 teaspoons of dried yeast. And let that mixture bloom for about 5 minutes. Next, combine 7 cups of flour with 1.5 teaspoons of salt, 6 tablespoons of olive oil, and the yeast water mixture. Mix it just until everything comes together and you can form a smooth surface. Don't worry about kneading the dough too much because the gluten will form itself as the dough ferments. Then, place your dough into a clean, oiled bowl, or a giant jar thing like I have if you can find it, and let it ferment for 8 hours or overnight. You can also pop this dough in the fridge and let it ferment for up to 3 days to form some really beautiful flavor. The next day, your dough will be bubbly and jiggly, and it should be smelling a little bit like beer. It's time to bring this dough back to life. Scrape it out onto a lightly floured work surface and knead it for a minute or two just to bring it back together. Then, let it rest for 5 to 10 minutes and divide it into 4 to 6 pieces. This recipe does make a lot of dough, so feel free to cut the recipe in half if you don't want that much dough. Now, shape each piece of dough into a little ball and let those rest on a lightly floured tray for another 5 to 10 minutes. Now, preheat your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. While your oven is preheating, shape your dough as best as you can into a rectangle. If it starts to spring back and isn't stretching, let it rest for another 5 minutes and then try again. Then, transfer your dough to a sheet pan, drizzle on a little olive oil, and let it bake for about 10 minutes. If it starts to bubble up, simply poke it down with a fork.
For our toppings, we're going to start by slicing 3 pears in half and then into slices. Then we'll lay them out on a sheet tray, salt them lightly, and bake them at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 10 to 15 minutes until they begin to lose some moisture and brown. Next, we'll toast up some crushed walnuts in a pan with a little butter, stirring constantly just until they begin to brown and turn fragrant. Finally, using the same pan, we'll add in a little more butter and caramelize 1 thinly sliced shallot over medium heat just until it turns translucent and softens. that's all we need to do to prepare our toppings. Now we'll start topping our flatbread. First, because we're a little OCD, we cut the crust of the flatbread to make it a crisp rectangle. Then we added a layer of brie, which has been brought up to room temperature with its rind removed, caramelized shallots, and a drizzle of balsamic reduction. Next, we'll add our pears, followed by our toasted walnuts, a few slices of prosciutto, enough arugula to fill in the gaps, and a little drizzle of olive oil. Now, place your flatbread into that 415 degree Fahrenheit oven for 10 to 12 minutes. Then pull it out and place it on a wire rack to cool for 5 to 10 minutes before sprinkling on a little fresh arugula and cutting it into slices.
We did it! We made our fall-inspired flatbread with pear, arugula, prosciutto, brie, walnuts, and balsamic. Did I get everything? Shallots.
Shallots. It almost didn't happen though, not gonna lie guys. We're cooking the dough. Huge bubble, huge pillow.
Yeah.
And we could not deplate it, so.
We don't like to lie to you guys here. And this is not going to be an exception. We are going to search for a better flatbread crust recipe.
Mm-hmm.
Because although this worked, it took a lot of effort. We had to do a lot of poking with a fork to keep the bubbles from forming.
Yeah.
And we ended up with about 3 wasted flatbreads. Well, they're not wasted.
They're still edible. We just like couldn't put toppings on it because it was like it's like a mound.
We're gonna find creative ways to eat those bubbly creations, but for the last one we poked it with the fork and we cut those clean edges with the knife.
Mm-hmm.
And it turned out pretty nice.
Yeah,
it looks good, and whenever I touch it, it feels crispy. So I am excited to dig in and see for myself with my mouth. This is actually good. Is there a fuzz on that?
Where?
What is
There's
this?
A fuzz from my sweater.
Oh my gosh.
Oops.
Fall flatbread, including actual cardigan. Wait, before I bite in. Hold on, people.
Pause.
Did you get a bite with prosciutto?
No.
Oh. I'm too excited over here. Take a bite with prosciutto.
Wow. That is so yummy.
Holy moly.
I'm glad I got the bite with the prosciutto because it's so nutty and like salty.
Mm-hmm.
And then the shallots are so sweet. They really add to the flavor of the flatbread.
Oh my gosh. The shallots and the balsamic.
Mm-hmm.
They're sweet and tangy. And the prosciutto is like crispy. Right?
I know. All is right in the world.
The crust was a challenge, but
yeah.
Those toppings are an absolute win.
I know. I'm glad we pushed through.
For real. The sweetness of the pear and the shallots and the balsamic, mm-hmm. and then the saltiness from the brie and the prosciutto, and then the nutty walnuts.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got the aromatic, sharp arugula.
Mm-hmm.
Just a nice combination of flavors and textures.
Yeah.
You got the crispiness, the chewiness in the prosciutto.
The dough is just like just the right thickness too. Like it's not too thick or too thin, and it has a little crispiness on the outside.
That's one thing I am proud of with the dough. It wasn't too thick.
Mm-hmm.
That was great.
I know.
Well, guys, I have arugula in my teeth. Besides that, if you like the video, hit the like button.
You know what to do.
You know what to do. We're not gonna beg. We'll beg if we have to, though. Please hit the like button. And if you want to see more videos, hit the subscribe button. And if you don't want to miss a video ever again, hit the notification bell. Lastly, we don't mention this every week, but we have a Patreon. We have a Patreon. We post all kinds of interesting videos, mm-hmm. from behind the scenes to... We can't tell you what's on Patreon. You have to pay us to find out. Mm-hmm. That's why they call it Patreon.
For the low, low price of $5 a month.
For the low, low price, you could be Patreon of the month.
That's one Starbucks for you, and it goes a long way.
Is that how much one Starbucks costs?
Yeah, basically. Sometimes more.
Oh my gosh, are you serious?
Yes. But your $5 will feed us for the whole month, so please.
That's insane. You need to quit that. Even if you don't donate to us, you need to quit that. It costs like 2 cents to make coffee at home. Well, people, that is enough ranting about finances. Thank you for watching, and we will see you on the next episode of Casual Gastronomy.